Hello, this is Mike Zamuda with techytube.com, and today we're going to look at the first part of creating a Hello World Windows 8 application with JavaScript. So we're currently at our Windows 8 desktop, so we'll go to the Start menu, and we will fire up Visual Studio Express. And we're going to create a new project, and we're going to use a template. You can see we already have a JavaScript one here, and we're going to do Windows Store, and for right now just a blank application, and we'll call this Hello World JS, and there we go. And here we are. So we'll just go through the files briefly here. So references, not too interesting. Because this is a Windows application, you're not going to be using the same libraries as you might for a purely web application written in JavaScript. So you're going to use the Windows library for JavaScript, which is there. We have a default CSS. There are pre-built Windows CSS files for particular themes, but you can also define your own in this file here. Few images here, and of course the JavaScript. Now this is the default skeleton that you're gonna see. Now one thing to keep in mind is that this will all be wrapped in a anonymous function, as you can see at the top there. And this is basically done due to variable namespace issues. We'll probably look at that in detail in a future video, but just so you know, that is something you should see every time in the main JavaScript file. And this is the app activation event handlers here. So basically there's two cases that you're really going to look at in this main piece of program here. One is that the app has just been started, and the other is that it's come back from being suspended according to the new Windows 8 process/application model. So it's kind of a introduction of one new factor in terms of you need to check what kind of launch you're looking at. But that's all I'm going to say about that. And we have a default HTML page. So basically this is your layout. As we can see, we have a few Microsoft libraries wrapped here. And these are actually all headers. This is the content right there. And we just have a basic content goes here. We have the app manifest, which is probably familiar to you if you're a .NET developer. And basically, this has to do with the local machine key. So there's not too much to say about that, more of a internal detail. But for right now, we'll try running this, and we'll just hit F5 here. And after some building, this is basically the splash screen for the new application. We'll be doing a video on how to create your own Windows 8 splash screen, much like we did for WPF splash screens. So as we can see right now, there's basically not too much here, just content goes here. So to end this, I'm going to show you the new way you can do it. You can still do Alt F4 and go back to Visual Studio via Alt Tab, but to close this application, we click and then drag down until we see it go down here. And then we're dropped back to the Start menu. So it's a little bit different behavior if you thought you'd be dropped right back to the Visual Studio window, but that'll also happen if you do Alt F4. So to go back, top left is all running programs. There's Visual Studio. Click on it. There we go. So that's basically how the app will launch for the first time, just being a basic blank application. So we're going to change the content just a little bit here. And we are following along with part one of the JavaScript tutorial on MSDN, which I will link in the video description. So we're just going to replace this with... Oh, my clipboard is not working again. So we'll be typing this manually in that case. There it is. All right. So we'll do H1, hello world, to make it a true hello world application. Then we're going to do P, and we'll say what's your name, and we're going to make an input control, we'll call it name input. And we'll do type equals text. So basically a text entry box, and we're going to create a button too. Basically ID is equal to hello button. Text on it will be say hello. And that's already ended, so that's fine. And one more thing, we'll put a div for the output. For a future section of this tutorial, but we will leave it as such for right now and leave the div empty. So, and we're going to run it, splash screen again, and we have a little bit of a different look. So this won't do anything right now, and if you're at the top of your game, you'll probably say, well, because we haven't hooked up any event handlers to it, and you would be correct. So we'll do all F4 this time, drop back again to start, and just go there to Visual Studio. So I think that's pretty much where we're going to wrap up this video, except for one thing. For the CSS include, and I clicked the wrong thing there. There we go. The CSS include, you'll have to look up the list of these files, but if we want to change that to a light background, we'll just reference the UI light CSS. And run this again. As we can see, we have a different theme, so it is kind of nice that there are predefined themes available. Whether you'll use them too much is a question, but it's good that they're there. So that's it for this video. We'll be continuing this part one of the tutorial with looking at how to create an event handler. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.